Today we're going to talk about the configuration of your USB connect. As you can see from the main menu, you have four items: CNC to USB, which would mean to save from the CNC. You have USB to CNC, which means we're going to send from this unit into the CNC control. We have DNC for drip feeding, and then we have setup. The first thing every person should do when they get the unit is go to setup, and you need to go through all these items. The first item you need to do is set up your baud rate to match your CNC machine. You can go up and down using the variety of buttons to choose the appropriate baud rate that your CNC machine is set to. The next item is going to be data parity and stop bits. You need to choose the appropriate one to match your CNC machine. Next is the flow control, or some people call it the software handshaking. You need to choose the appropriate method, and then you will go to the next item, which is EOB delay, which is end of block delay. You can choose anywhere from no delay all the way up to 1 second. What this does will slow down the transfer on certain controls that it's required. The next item is EOB characters. That's end of block characters. You need to choose the appropriate combination that your control is using: carriage return line feed, line feed carriage return, or there's line feed carriage return, and then there's line feed only, carriage return only, or non-binary if necessary. And the last items are started TX. This is a character that you put at the beginning of the file. As you can see, we have choices of Simmons for the Simmons controls. We have none, null characters, and percent signs. And then you have end of text characters. This will be the character that's embedded at the end of the file. As you can see, we have percent sign, null characters, none, and EOT, and no change. And the last item you're going to do is the automatic. We want to leave it at automatic unless you're directed by someone at shop floor automations.